Hi, in this video, I'll introduce Excel for those of you who have not used it before. I'll run through some basics and do some math examples. Now, Google Sheets is similar to Excel and it's free. I will try to do a similar video for Google Sheets, but until then, if you watch this video, you will be able to get started using Google Sheets because they are very much alike. Excel or Google Sheets is a spreadsheet program. Originally, it was used to imitate the old-fashioned ledger sheets that people used in accounting, but now it's a lot more powerful. Like the old ledger sheets, though, when you work in Excel, you should think in terms of columns. Each column should contain the same type of things. In this old ledger sheet, for example, all the months go down the same column, all the dates and all the years as well. Each column contains its own kind of data. Moving from paper to computer in Excel, you get a large sheet of several thousand columns and rows. The rows are numbered 1, 2, 3, etc., and the columns are labeled A, B, C. Each box is called a cell, and it's labeled column row. So this box is A1. Next to it is B1, then C1, and going down you get C2, C3, etc. You can type anything in the cell. Whatever you type belongs to that cell. If you type a long phrase, it may look like it's in the next cell, but it really isn't. If you look up here in the formula bar, you see that this cell has all of the to be or not to be, that is the question. If you go over to the cell B1, you see that it contains nothing in it. So visually, if that bothers you, if you want to keep what you type to stay in a cell, you should choose wrap text. So I click on the corner here to select all cells in the entire sheet and I click wrap text. Then all text in the cell will wrap around. If I type a math expression into a cell, it doesn't know that it's math. It thinks it's just me typing things. Except for this, if I type something like 4 minus x or 4 over x, Excel will think that I'm typing a date and it will reformat it automatically. If I want to make Excel compute things, I need to start with the equal sign. So equal 4 plus 5 equals 4 times 5, etc. Now here's the part where Excel gets really helpful. Let's say I want a column of x values, a column of 2x, and a column of 4x minus 7. I put a number in for x, let's say I put 3.14. Over here I want 2 times x, so I type equals 2 times. And the number that I'm multiplying by is in the cell A2, so I arrow over or click on that cell, 2 times the A2. Hit enter. Now over here, I want 4x minus 7, so I type equals 4 times, click on the x value, then minus 7, enter. Great. If I want to compute 2x and 4x minus 7 again, but with new values of x, I just go in A2 and change the number. The rest of the sheet update themselves. If you click any of these cells, you will see that even though the answer is displayed numerically, up here, the cell actually contains the formula. That's why they update with the new values of x. Next, I want to show how to do it. If I want a full table where I get all kinds of different x values and I want to compute 2x and 4x minus 7 for all of them. I can do that by just copying and pasting these formulas. So right now, this cell contains 2 times A2. If I copy this cell down, the formula also moves down. Control C, Control V. I'm down to B3 and the formula says 2 times A3. The formula moves with the cell. I can copy and paste the entire line down. Click and drag, Control C. And I want to paste it all these rows, so I click and drag, Control V. In summary, when you reference a cell, Excel remembers where that cell is in relation to where you are. When you copy a formula, that reference moves with the copying. Let's try something where you actually don't want the reference to move. Suppose you don't want just 4x minus 7, but you want a general mx minus 7 where you may want to change the value of m. Let's say over here I put m equals 4. And here I want to compute mx minus 7, so equal. Click on the m cell times, click on the x cell minus 7. There we go. That works. Let's copy and paste it down. Whoa, something went wrong. This is what happened. The value of m was f1. That was correct for the first row, but when we copy it down, the reference to m also gets moved down to f2, f3, etc. We don't want that. We want to keep the reference to m to stay fixed at f1. Don't move down even as we copy the formula down. That's called an absolute reference. To keep the reference fixed at a cell and not move down when we copy and paste, use the dollar sign. So instead of F1, use $F, $1. It fixes the column at F and it fixes the row at 1. Copy, paste. That works. Now that's a little annoying that you have to type in the cell address instead of just clicking. Luckily, there's a keyboard shortcut. In Windows, it's the F4 key. On a Mac, use Apple T. T short for toggle. Okay, so equal, click on the cell for M. F4 to make the reference absolute. Then continue on. Times X minus 7. Copy and paste. With the absolute reference, copying won't move the location of M. Next topic is math functions. Excel comes with a large library of math and financial and other functions. Google Sheets also has all of those. Let's say I want to take the square root of x. I go equal, then start typing the word square root, starting with s. A bunch of functions appear. I can look for the one I want. This looks like it. It gives me the description of the function. I read it and make sure it's what I want. Then I double click to use it. It says to enter the number, which is x, so I click on the cell with x, close parentheses, enter. I can copy and paste. You can see that when I try to get the square root of a negative number, I get an error. Now let's do something fancy. I want log base 3 of x. So equal, letter L, and I click at what I think is the function I want. There's ln, that's the natural log. Log 10, I can guess that it means log base 10. I want log base 3, so I click on log. I read the description. That seems to be what I want. Double click. It tells me how to enter my number. It says number, comma, base. The bracket means the base is optional. So if I don't type in the base, Excel will use some kind of default value. And I click on the cell with X, comma, 3 for the base, close paren. And copy and paste. And the log of 0 and of log of negative return an error. If I'm curious what the default is for the base, then I can do this. I move to an empty cell so I won't mess up my work, and I click on fx up here. I type my search term, log. I click on help on this function. A help page pops up. Over here, it tells me if the base is omitted, then it is assumed to be 10. Okay, next thing I want to show you is how to sort. So let's say I want to sort so that the X column is in numerical order. Then I also need to move the rest of the columns with it. First, I highlight all the columns that will move together. In the menu, I click Data, then Sort. Over here, because my columns have headers, I make sure this box is checked. That way the header row stays in place and isn't sorted with the data. Then I choose what to sort by. I choose the X column. And over here under order, I specify how I want things sorted, smallest to largest or largest to smallest. I choose smallest to largest. Here I click OK. Now my list is in numerical order of X from smallest to largest. Alright, the last thing I want to show you is the sum function. Let me insert a new column. I highlight the column, I right click on the label, and I choose insert. I type the word total here. In Excel, it's important that you label everything. Otherwise, you look at the sheet and it's just a bunch of numbers and you have no idea what's going on. Alright, equals sum. Here's the sum function. I double click on it. To choose what to add, I click and drag the cells I want. Close parentheses. Enter. I can see here that it shows a range from one cell to the next cell with a colon in between. I can copy and paste to the rest of the columns. The last two columns return an error because there are errors in the data, so the total is an error. All right, that's a lot of information for a first-time outing with Excel. So now's a good time to stop. Hope it helps. Thanks for watching. Bye.